Hi everyone, and welcome to another video on Windows 11. As you might have heard, since a few days, Microsoft has released their 2023 update of Windows 11, better known as 23H2. As I did some earlier videos on getting Windows 11 on unsupported hardware, this one is no different and covers upgrading to Windows 11 23H2 on non-supported hardware. There are several scenarios that might apply for you, so I decided to split these up in separate videos. This video is about upgrading an existing Windows 11 installation that is on the previous version 22H2 already, and I will explain how to upgrade that to the latest version 23H2. Other videos will be about performing a fresh install of Windows 11 23H2 on unsupported hardware or about upgrading from Windows 10. For these different scenarios, I've put a card here and you can find a link in the description as well. Since Microsoft released Windows 11 in October 2021, there has been some hardware limitations. These limitations include a limited list of processor support, the requirement for secure boot, and a TPM 2.0 module. In case one of these requirements on your machine is not met, you have an unsupported system, and without any workarounds, you will not be able to install Windows 11 on that machine. Since this video is about upgrading from an existing Windows 11 installation on unsupported hardware, you are most likely fully aware of that, as it means you have used one of the known methods to work around these limitations or hardware checks in the past. For this video, I will use my trusty Dell OptiPlex 9020, which I also used for previous videos on Windows 11. It is equipped with a 4th generation Intel Core i5 CPU, which is not supported, and it doesn't meet the TPM 2.0 requirement either. So in short, this machine is not officially compatible or qualified to run Windows 11 by Microsoft, but currently it is running the 22H2 version of that OS. So far, minor feature and also security updates seem to come in just fine through Windows Update on unsupported hardware. Last year, with the release of 22H2, an unsupported system would not automatically update to that new version. This time, for 23H2, the situation is a bit different. While for the previous version, the new features came in a single, large update package, which was not seen on unsupported machines, this time the updates are offered through a few separate update packages in Windows Update, with KB5031455 as being one of the more important ones. It looks like this package is offered on an unsupported system, and it does enable all the features that are in 23H2, at least for now. What does not get offered to unsupported systems is the 23H2 enablement package called KB5027397. This is a very small update that moves the version of the operating system to 23H2. Fortunately, it can just be downloaded and installed manually on an unsupported system to bring that one fully to 23H2. On a supported system, this is how that would look like in Windows Update. So, in short, you should get the required updates automatically, and once everything is up to date, you can manually install that enablement package to fully move your installation to 23H2. I'll go through these steps in a bit, but in case that wouldn't work for you, I also have a second method, which you can find further in this video, that should work for any system that's already on Windows 11, even if it's still on 21H2, or in case you experience issues with installing the updates that I just mentioned. Let's start with the first and easiest method, using Windows Update. So, in Settings, System, About, on my system, you can see here the machine that I will be using for this video is, as I mentioned, on Windows 11 22H2. We can also see that some of the new features are not available yet, like the option to never hide labels or combine on the taskbar. From here, all we need to do first is to go to Windows Update and check for updates. Then let Windows install all of the updates. We're looking specifically for the update that I mentioned, called KB5031455. I did notice that in some cases, the update which we need to get is installed automatically without the need for further confirmation, like is the case here. But in other cases, you need to click Download and Install on a banner like this one. Not sure why that difference exists, but that's how it is. Once the update is installed, we need to restart the system as is suggested, and then wait for the update to complete. After the reboot, we can see that our version is still on 22H2 in System About. If we check again for updates in Windows Update, we can see that everything that was available is installed. If we go to Update History, we can verify that that important KB503-1455 is present. That also means that now all new features, despite the version still being listed as 22H2, are already available. So if you go to Taskbar Settings, then Taskbar Behaviors, now we do have that Never Combine option here. Also, in File Explorer, as you can see, the new interface is active. The next step now, as mentioned, is to install the 23H2 enablement update. I've put a link to download that in the description here, and you can also find it on my blog. As you can see, this is a pretty small file. Once downloaded, just run the executable, and restart the system once again when asked. And after the reboot, if we go to Settings, System, About, we can see that we are fully on 23H2 now. WinVar is telling us exactly the same. So hopefully these steps will help you to upgrade completely to 23H2 on your unsupported hardware. Now, as I mentioned in the beginning, if this does not work for you or you are still on 21H2, you can use another method. The way we will do this is by downloading the Windows 11 ISO from Microsoft's website, copy the contents to our SSD, and modify a single file, which is responsible for the hardware checks. This will allow us to continue and upgrade while bypassing the hardware check. So let's start our browser and head over to Microsoft's Windows 11 download page. You have several options here, and earlier for 22H2, I recommended here to continue by downloading the Media Creation tool and then use that to download ISO. For Windows 11 23H2, I noticed that if you use an ISO that is generated with that tool, it would only upgrade to 22H2 somehow. So instead, we need to download the ISO directly from here. Select the only option in the Download Windows 11 Disk Image section, Windows 11 Multi-Edition ISO, from the list and click Download. Now comes the tricky part. We need to select the correct language for the ISO, and that's more important than you might think, as it has to match with the base installed language of your current installation. That doesn't mean it necessarily matches with the current display language. In order to double check this, we need to launch a command prompt as administrator. To do so, press the Windows key or Start button and type cmd. This should select the command prompt, and then here click on Run as administrator. Here we can type the command dism/online/getintl and press Enter. In the output you get here, you should find the base language of your Windows installation. In my case, it is English United States, so that is also the language that I need to select for the download. After selecting that, we can click on Confirm and wait for the 64-bit download button to appear, then click on it to start downloading the ISO file. Our download completed, so we can close our browser and navigate to the Downloads folder to continue. Now we need to mount that downloaded ISO file. This can simply be done by double-clicking on the file. As you can see, this results in an additional virtual drive with the contents of the ISO. In case double-clicking wouldn't work, you can also right-click on the ISO and choose for Mount. On that mounted ISO, we have the required files right here, but these are read-only. Since we need to modify that file to bypass the hardware checks, we need to copy the contents of the ISO to a new folder on the desktop. Let me first create that folder. I'll call it 23H2, and then we can simply drag the contents of the mounted ISO to that new folder. After all files are copied, you can unmount the ISO file by right-clicking on the virtual drive and choosing Eject. If you would be low on space At this point, you can also delete the downloaded ISO file from your downloads folder, because from here, we will only work with that copy on a desktop. If you would try to run the installation without any modifications at this point, this is what you would see. You can see that that setup application is running the checking your PC step for some time, and then it tells us that our hardware is not compatible, as we already knew. To work around that, navigate to the sources folder and the copy of the files on the desktop. Here, find a file called app-razorbest.dll. Right-click on it, and then choose Open With, and choose Notepad from the list. This brings up the binary contents of the file. We don't need to read it, just select everything by pressing Ctrl-A or go to Edit Select All and press the backspace or delete button to delete everything in there. Then just save the file and quit Notepad. That's all it takes. Simply as it is, this will disable the hardware checks. So let's navigate back to that 23H2 folder and run setup from here. On the first screen, click on Change How Setup Downloads Updates and choose for Not Right Now. This will prevent the setup from re-downloading that modified file. Now, click Next, and as you could see, the checking your PC step only takes a very short time and doesn't complain anymore, simply because we removed the contents of that DLL file. Click Accept here, and eventually you should end up with the Ready to Install screen. This is what you need to get here: install Windows 11 and keep personal files and applications. If you do not get the option to keep your files and apps, something went wrong, and in most cases this is due to the earlier mentioned mismatch with the language. This is how that would look like, and as you can see, it's also clarified as well at the bottom of that window. All we need to do now is to click Install and then be patient. After waiting for roughly 20 minutes in my case, we are greeted with our fresh Windows 11 23H2 desktop. Let's have a look now at Settings, System, About. And as you can see, we've successfully upgraded our Windows 11 22H2 install to Windows 11 23H2. And as with the previous method, WinVar shows us the same information, of course. At this point, you can delete that copy of the installation files which you made on the desktop, as they are no longer needed and they take up quite some space. If you have kept that downloaded ISO file, you're safe to delete that one as well. And while going to Downloads and File Explorer, we can see another confirmation of the upgrade as we got that new File Explorer interface. And after deleting the ISO, we can also check the options for taskbar behavior by going to Taskbar Settings. Since 23H2, it allows you again to not hide labels or combine taskbar buttons. And after aligning the start button to the left as well, this finally goes back to the way I've always liked it. That was it for the video. Thanks a lot for watching. Let me know how this worked for you, and if you would have any questions, let me know in the comments and I'll do my best to provide an answer. If you have liked this video, a thumbs up is always nice, and if you're into this kind of videos, feel free to subscribe to my channel. Thanks again, and hope to see you back here soon.